In this video, we will discuss how to calculate area under the curve using origin. As we know that area under the curve signifies many physical and geometrical interpretations in physics. In fact, it is a product of the quantities of functions on the x and y axes. For example, we consider a function f of x and the behavior is like this. And we want to find out area under the curve of this function. Now the desired area is this one, and as we know that there is no fixed shape on which we can calculate this area, so the best approximation we will have to consider a rectangle on it. And as we know that the rectangle of side A and B is having the area AB, and in terms of f of x, I can write the area is f of x multiplied by x. But here I know that I have calculated an additional area, which is this one. I can remove this additional area by considering small rectangles here. I will cover this whole area under the curve with respective areas of the rectangles is A1, A2, A3 and A4, and the total area is equal to this, and in terms of f of x and x I can write it like this. Now here I see that a very small additional area is here, so I will have to eliminate this area as well in order to calculate the exact area under the curve. So what I can do, I will have to consider many small rectangles here, and then I will have to eliminate that additional area calculation. The best I can do when I will consider this delta x so small that it can be replaced with a differential x dx. In that case, the summation will go to integration, and I will write area under the curve is f of x dx. When I consider the x-ray diffraction, and I'm having this curve and I want to find out the area under this curve. As I know that height in XRD and the width in XRD are having their own importances, so the area is having the composite information about the crystalline state of the sample. As I know that area under the curve will give me the total diffraction volume, and it gives, in other words, the quality of the crystalline state, which we call as phase fraction. Less area or sharp peak will indicate single crystallinity, and the wider peak will be an indication of a polycrystalline state. Now, in order to calculate area under the curve, I am plotting this XRD data here. I will now find the area under these curves. So I can focus on a specific curve or all the curves at the same time. So to find area under the curve, I will have to go to analysis and then peak and baseline and to the peak analyzer, and I will open the dialog. As I open the dialog, then a preview opens here, which will give me indications as I go on with this menu. Now I'm doing the integrate peaks, so I will click next, and here the baseline mode. So the red line is shown here, it is the baseline. As this is already baseline corrected data, so I will not do any change here. And I will go to next, and then I can click auto subtract the baseline because it is already having no effect on my data, and I will click next. It is saying that currently the number of peaks are zero, so I will have to find the peaks with the auto find, and here they are. So it has found three peaks, as they are having the most of the contribution from these three peaks, while these two peaks are not auto found. So I can found them manually, but let's go on with these three peaks. And I go next. Now it will indicate some area here, and the all peaks are selected here, and the number of peaks are 3. Now if I want to select only one peak from it, then I can untick this one, and here I write only one peak, and you see only one peak is selected. Now if I want to move this one to this peak, if I am interested in this peak area or this one, so for that I will have to click here to adjust on preview graph, and with the arrows I will now select this one, and with the arrows I can move it to this one or to the next peak. So it can be done manually as well, but it is always better to find out the area under all peaks so that less effort is done and we will have more information. These all three peaks are selected, and I will click finish, and here the area is. The peak 1 is having this much area, peak 2 having this much area, and peak 3 is with this much area. This way we can calculate area under the curve and origin. Thank you for watching the video.